So good morning friends, yesterday we have solved some problems on cone clutches. So today we will discuss first the theory part on centrifugal clutch, then we will solve one problem on the centrifugal clutch. Already all the four clutches we have discussed in one presentation, that is single plate clutch, multi plate clutch, cone clutch and centrifugal clutch. So as I said at that time, when I start problem, once again I give the introduction part and the analysis part. So the analysis part today we'll see first, after discussing the analysis part, then we'll go for the problem part. Okay, let us see how a centrifugal clutch works. So let us see how a centrifugal clutch works. You can see in the diagram, so in the diagram what you can see, so there is a shaft corresponding to either motor or some engine is there, and there is a rim is there on the outside. Outside there is a rim, it is there. So the rim inside and the shaft outside, you can see four brake shoes which are nothing but the centrifugal clutch shoes. So these shoes are arranged such a way that they are placed in between the rim inner and the shaft outer location. In between them there is a spring. So as the shaft speed increases, then these shoes, brake shoes, will start moving from its location and going and attaching the outer rim. So when it happens, how it happens means, we already stated there are springs are available. So the springs will have certain initial force built in the spring. So if the centrifugal force exceeds that initial spring force, then only that shoe will move out of that location. Okay, so you can see here certain terminology I have used it. What is the terminology? M is the mass of each shoe. And what is R? Capital R and small r. There are two terms are there. Capital R is inner radius of the pulley or rim. Then what is small r? Small r is the distance of center of mass of each shoe from the shaft axis, isn't it? Then coming to number of shoes are represented by N. How many shoes in this case? You can see there are four shoes are there. Then there are two more terminology. One is omega and omega dash. What is omega and what is omega dash? Omega is the normal speed of the shaft, which is in radians per second. That means once the clutch starts complete action, it runs with a particular speed. That constant speed is called omega, which is attained once the clutch is completely in the function part. Then coming to the omega dash, what is this omega dash? Speed at which the shoe moves forward. Just now I said there is a spring and the spring is with under initial tension. So after certain amount of force which is developed by this shoe, then only the shoe will go and attack with the rim. So what is that amount of force required and what is the speed at that time it needs to cross that position? That is what? Omega dash. Then what is mu? Mu is the coefficient of friction between the brake shoe and the rim, isn't it? So these terms which we use it for analysis part. Okay, let me simply, in a simple line diagram, I will show what are those terminology. So you can see there is a rim. This is the rim. It is a simple line diagram. And this is the shaft. And you have your brake shoe. Four number are there and I am showing only one. Okay, then you can see here there is a point where the center of gravity of the shoe will be there, okay? And the distance from here to the center of the shaft is nothing but r, small r. Then what is capital R? That is the inner radius of the rim. So when it comes and contact here, there will be an inner radius. So the inner radius is capital R. Okay, so M is mass of the shoe. M is the mass of the shoe. So these are the terminology which you require. One is M, one is capital R, another one is small r. M is mass and omega dash. Just now I said omega is the speed of clutch. And what is omega dash? So this is shoe start moving. So just it starts moving, that is this. And you can also see here there is a spring. This is the spring. Spring. Okay, then what is the analysis part we require here? Let us see or how we can write the necessary equation. So M is the mass, R is the radius, okay, that is center of gravity radius, omega is angular velocity. So you can write the centrifugal force, okay, centrifugal force, okay, M R omega square at full speed. And the centrifugal force, okay, that is M, okay, R omega dash square, that is beginning of shoe movement. Beginning of the shoe movement. So now the difference of this is, MR omega square minus omega dash square is the net force. And frictional force is mu into M into R into omega square minus omega dash square. Then how many shoes are there? N number of shoes are there. Okay. Then mu M R omega square minus omega dash square into N, that gives the frictional force. Then what is the frictional torque? So this frictional torque is force into the distance. What is the distance? Where this force is acting? Here on the tangential surface of this brake shoe. That is distance of R. So mu M R omega square minus omega dash square. Okay. N into T. So frictional torque, you can get it by this relation mu m r omega square minus omega dash square, okay, omega dash square into n. N is the number of shoes. T, this is n is the number of shoes, not t, sorry, r. R is the radius of the rim. So with this we can get what is the frictional torque that it develops in the process of centrifugal clutch operation. So once you get the torque, you can get the power. Power is equal to, power is T into omega. Okay. Suppose in case you are given with the permissible bearing pressure, or the pressure and the length and width of the bearing shoe. Okay. Suppose if you are given length and width of the bearing shoe and permissible pressure is given, then you can get the amount of the force. That is the frictional force, how much it can bear. So this is another relation. So this is the another relation you can use to solve the problem. Length of the shoe, width of the shoe and permissible pressure gives the force that it can withstand. That force here, it is a frictional force. So using these relations, we will solve the problem. So we'll solve one problem so that you will be very clear. Okay, we'll see the problem. Relations, we will solve the problem. So we'll solve one problem so that you will be very clear. Okay, we'll see the problem. Let us solve a problem on a centrifugal clutch. So the data goes like this. A centrifugal clutch transmits 20 kilowatts of power at 750 rpm. The engagement of the clutch commences 70% of the running speed. The inside diameter of the drum is 400 mm and the distance of the center of mass of each shoe is 40 mm from the contact surface. Determine the abit, mass of each shoe, then bbit, net force exerted by each shoe on the drum surface, and the third part is power transmitted when the shoe is worn 2 mm and is not readjusted. Assume coefficient of friction be 0.25 and stiffness of the spring is 150 kN per meter. So a beautiful problem which gives almost the entire centrifugal clutch all complexities in a single problem. Just now we discussed about the centrifugal clutch, the equations required. Here those equations we use, and at the same time we use a certain concept related to your springs and stiffness and other related part. So let us first write what is the data given. So it is the centrifugal clutch, and what is the power? So the power is equal to, so how much it is? 20 kilowatts, that is 20,000 watts. And what is the speed? 750 rpm. Then the engagement of the clutch commences 70% of the running speed. This is what when I discussed. So the shoe starts engaging, okay, at a speed other than its actual final running speed. Here he has given the 70% of the running speed, 70% of the full speed, it starts functioning. That means we can write the relation between omega and omega dash. So that is the relation where you get here. So omega and omega dash. So omega dash is equal to 0.7 times of omega. Okay. Then the inner diameter of the drum is 400 mm. So that is the D inner. And that is what we are writing simply D. 0.4 meter. So there I can get a radius. What is this radius? Capital R. That is D by 2. That is 0.2 meters. 0.2 meters. Okay. And the distance of the center of mass each shoe is 40 mm from the contact surface. So what is this? Let me show. So here this is the shoe and there is a brake drum. So this is the center. Here to here we defined is R, and this is the mass center, and he has given this distance, where this distance is how much? It is 40 mm. That is nothing but, as per our terminology, small r. Okay, so I can write small r is capital R minus 40, or mm if I write 0.2 minus 0.04. So the radius you got 200, and that 40 mm has subtracted, then you get 160 mm, then that is nothing but 0.16 meters. Okay, then what else is available with us? We have the other data, coefficient of friction, how much it is? 0.25, and stiffness of the spring is K is 150 into 10 power 3 newton per meter. He has given kilo newton per meter. Okay, and how much it is worn out? It is worn out by an amount of, say, delta 2 mm. So that is required for the third beat. So first beat it does not require. So what is the requirement? Find. So bit 1 is mass of the shoe. And what is the second beat? What is the second beat? Net force, F. And the third beat, because of delta, okay, of and the spring K, what is the power transmitted? This. Okay, so this problem we can see, we can solve very easily with the basic equations which we have. Now let us see what is omega first, 2 pi n by 60, that is 2 pi 750 by 60. Omega is 2 pi n by 60. So this gives 78.5 radians per second. Then what is omega dash with the given data? 0.7 times of omega, that is 0.7 times of 78.5. So 0.7 times of 78.5, which gives 55 radians per second. This is the first part. Then what is the next requirement? Power. Okay, so power is equal to T into omega. So what is the power with us? The power is 20,000. Okay, watts, then it is T, and omega, that is 78.5. Then you get the value of torque. So what is the value of torque? So the torque value you get 254.8. So this is 254. Newton meter. This is from the given equation. Then what is the equation we know for the torque? in a centrifugal clutch, that is mu times of m r omega square minus omega dash square. Okay, that gives your force, frictional force into radius into number of shoes. Let me substitute the entire data. Torque is 254.8, mu 0.25, m unknown, I have to find out r. So what is r? So here you can see, what is the value of r? This is r is equal to 0.16. This is the r, okay, into omega. Where is the omega? 78.5 whole square minus 55 whole square. And what is capital R? Capital R is given 0.2. Capital R is equal to 0.2. Then how many shoes are there? There are 4 shoes into 4. So by simplifying this equation, okay, by simplifying this equation, you get mass is equal to 2.538 kg. Mass is equal to 2.538 kg. This is the first part of the problem, that is a bit. That is the a bit. Okay, then what is b bit? What is the net force? So what is the net force? So how to get the net force? Net force, okay, the net force is m r omega square minus omega dash square. Already m is available with us, 2.538, and r is 0.16, then omega 78.5 square, omega dash square 55 square. Then by substituting this, you get the force value, okay, the net force value, which is 1274 newtons. So up to this, there is no difficulty. Now listen carefully the third part, which is very, very important. What is asked in the third part? It happened, okay, during the operation, the shoe was worn out by a 2 mm, okay? Then what is the amount of the power now it is transmitted, and the stiffness of the spring is 150 kN per meter. So let me first write, what is the spring force exerted? Spring force exerted. So what is the spring force exerted? M R omega dash square. So how we get, let us see. As we said, the functioning of the clutch starts after reaching certain speed. What is that speed? We said that speed is omega dash. Here we said that is a 0.7 times of original running steady speed. So there the spring force start functioning. So that is why I write omega dash square. M is the mass and R is the radius. Okay. So what is mass? 2.538. What is the radius? 0.16. And what is omega dash? 55 square. So by substituting this, you get the value of the force is 1228 newtons. Okay, now let us see how much amount of shoe has worn out. It was worn out by an amount of 2 mm. So if it worn out to 2 mm, then the spring will move towards the rim. Then it exerts some additional force. So the additional force is delta into K. What is delta? 2 mm. What is K? He has given stiffness is 150 into 10 power 3 Newton per meter. So that is 150 10 power 3. This is per meter. So once again by 10 power 3 Newton per mm, which gives 300 Newton. Okay. Then what is the net spring force? Net spring force is the initial force, that is initial force plus worn out force. Worn out force, that is 1228 plus 300. Then how much you get? It is so 1528 newtons. Okay, so now what my requirement? The new power to be transmitted. So how we can get the new power to be transmitted? Okay, let us see. So this is the net spring force. Then what is the final force due to this centrifugal force as well as the spring force? We can write. So I am using this part of the board. Okay, so I am using here F is equal to M R nu omega square minus this force 1528. So why we have written R nu? Because now there is a 2 mm of worn out is happened to shoe, so the shoe has reached towards the rim. Now the center of gravity of your shoe is not at the previous distance, which it was mentioned at 160 mm, isn't it? How it has shifted? It has shifted like this. Here the shoe is earlier at this location. Okay, I have stated this is my R, which is 160 mm or 0.16. Then worn out, it was worn out by 2 mm. Then it has spring caused it to move towards this. This center has been shifted to a new position, which I call R nu. That is 0.16. Okay. And what is the amount it is caused? 2 mm. So that is 0.002, that is 0.162 mm. So that new R I will take here. So M is already known to me, 2.538. Then R nu 0.162. Then omega square. What is omega? Here you can see the value of omega, 78.5 square minus 1528. So this gives the force F is 1005. So what is the total frictional torque? Total frictional torque T is equal to mu F R n. So what is mu in the given problem? Mu is 0.25. And what is this F? 1005. And what is our R? Our R is 0.2. And number of shoes are 4. This gives the value of torque. So this gives a value of torque is 201. So this gives a torque of 201. Okay, this is the torque value Newton meter. Then asked one is a power. Power is equal to T into omega. So 201 into omega. What is the omega value? 78.5. Then you get 15,782. Watts. 15,782 watts, or else 15.78 kilowatts. Okay, so the third bit is a complexity available. That complexity, how we can solve, let us see. Originally there is a spring and that exerts some certain spring force. What is that spring force exerted? That is mr omega dash square, which we got it 1228. And because of wear and tear, there is a 2 mm is worn out. So this 2 mm worn out causes the additional spring force, that is 2 into stiffness, 300. So the net force due to spring is initial force plus worn out force. What is the initial force? 1228, and worn out is 300, then it is 1528. So this is the spring force. Then what about the centrifugal force, which is due to the mass of the brake shoe, that is mr omega square. And what is this r nu? That means when there is a worn out, the shoe will move towards right. So when it moves towards right, there is an 2 mm additional radius is added. So that is why I have added that 160 plus 2, 162 mm, that converted in meter, then m r nu omega square minus the spring force of 1528 gives 1005. So torque, we know the torque is equal to force into friction into radius into number of shoes. So friction 0.25, force 1005, radius 0.2, number of shoes 4. So I get torque. Once I get torque, the power can be obtained. Power is equal to 2 into omega. That is what? It is 15782 watts or 15.78 kilowatts. Okay. So this problem covers almost all types of requirements in centrifugal clutch. Thank you.